Hello to all robotics enthusiasts out there. This is Robois Research Reviews with our 7th episode. Today it will be musical. We want to present you the research of an awesome soft robotic piano playing hand, which can play simple musical phrases by just moving its wrists. The human hand has a very delicate and complex structure. This allows muscles and joints in the hand a great range of movement and precision. So it's reasonable to take it as an inspiration for building robotic hands. Nevertheless, it's one of the most challenging tasks to create a robot which is able to be as flexible as the human hand. Just consider this excellent and outstanding piano artist. His hands allow for unique precision and maneuverability. We want to explore what it takes to develop more flexible robotic hands, which are able to play the piano like a pro. The paper we present today considers the passive dynamics of mechanically complex systems, like a hand, as an approach to improving adaptability, dexterity, and richness of behavioral diversity of such robotic manipulators. The robotic hand is able to play simple musical phrases on the piano by just moving its wrists. Well, do you recognize this song? But what is actually so challenging in building robotic hands which are able to play the piano? Robotic hands might be very complex systems, so they require a lot of computing power and energy to control. One solution to this problem is to offload some of the control into the hand, so that the hand can at least partially control itself without input from a computer. This concept is called passivity and has been very successful in nature. For instance, humans walk using passivity to save energy, which has in turn inspired passive walking robots that can partially use their own momentum to continue walking. Researchers of the University of Cambridge developed a 3D-printed anthropomorphic robotic hand with integrated materials of different flexibilities. It consists of solid bones as well as flexible ligaments and anthropomorphic joints. Each ligament had a defined directional stiffness, meaning that its flexibility never changed. But the directional stiffness means that the joint is more flexible in certain directions, allowing the same joint to have different stiffnesses depending on how the finger presses down. For instance, the finger was more flexible pressing straight down and less flexible when pressing down sideways. Three types of ligaments were tested: joint stiffness, thumb abduction and adduction, as well as band stiffness. The actuator was placed in the wrist, outside of the hand, so that the actuation mechanism was not in the finger at all. This creates a conditional model where the behavior of the hand depends on the ligaments and then interacts with the environment, and subsequently creates another conditional model as the behavior of the hand changes based on that interaction. Therefore, by actuating the wrist, it is possible to choose how the hand interacts with the piano, allowing the embodied intelligence of the hand to determine how it interacts with the environment. In order to maximize the number of behaviors of the hand, various stiffnesses in different ligaments were tested. The behaviors represent whether the hand could play songs of different styles on the piano without changing ligaments. Three different musical pieces were chosen due to the different requirements: Toccata, Alligator Crawl, and Rhapsody in Blue. To play Toccata, there must be at least one finger with high stiffness to achieve the high frequency and high force staccato playing style, while the other fingers have low stiffness so as to interfere as little as possible. Alligator Crawl requires a low handspan stiffness to allow sideways translation of the finger to achieve the octave spread, while also keeping the fingers relatively stiff to achieve articulated notes. For Rhapsody in Blue, thumb stiffness must be set appropriately to allow a slurred transition between notes. By combining these constraints, they came up with a hand that could perform a variety of pieces, purely through wrist actuation and hand passivity. By using state-of-the-art 3D printed human-like soft hands, we are now able to explore the importance of physical designs even better, and the amount of machine learning required to control the hand is also reduced. But this isn't the only robot musician. At Drawboys, we have worked on getting Robert to play the marimba in simulation and in reality. We've developed techniques to allow Robert to play the marimba, repeat a music sequence that someone else plays, and play an improvised riff on a tune that he has heard before. Robert is already practicing to play the piano. Just imagine Robert as the next Ludwig van Beethoven. So, be ready for the cutest humanoid robot to play the piano. The Robot Project is an open source project with the goal to build a robot as good as the human body. We created an open platform for robot development that unites researchers, companies, students and artists from a broad spectrum of disciplines. Robai means full-stack robotics, from mechanics to electronics, to control to cognitive systems. Artificial intelligence is everywhere, and we work on all levels to make Robai truly intelligent. The Robai team aims to build better, more useful robots by adopting principles from biology and to help humans with musculoskeletal limitations through better prosthetics, better training and exoskeletons. So if you are interested and want to know more, check out our website robot.org or the GitHub account github.com/robot. Thanks for watching another episode of R-Cube. See you soon and stay curious.